Everyone, Wanderbots here, and welcome to Unicorn Overlord. I'm not entirely sure why the two rings are linked together like that. That seems wildly impractical if you're supposed to be wearing them. But maybe if you're joined a little bit more than at the hip.
There seem to be magical rings that the villains were after, or something of that sort. There are all these really cool people in this dark armor and such. But then again, there's a lot of armor in this game.
Yeah, so this is the latest game by Vanillaware, the people who made, 13 Sentinels, Odin Sphere. That's the main one that I always think of them
for. I love the way they draw their characters.
Yeah, they've always had this lovely and very signature art style. And so I was super excited to see that they were making this one, because it is a fantasy strategy RPG that harkens back to, you know, strategy RPGs of the, 80s and 90s?
You're playing on a grid, correct?
I think so. I think it's a little bit more grid-based. Actually, I haven't looked too closely at the gameplay because I'd like to be surprised. But before we begin, I should say a very quick thank you to ATLUS, Sega, and Vanillaware for sponsoring this video, and that Unicorn Overlord is going to be available as available on the Switch, Xbox, PlayStation 4, and 5. So Xbox, S and S, PS4, and 5. And will be out on March 8th. But if you want to play it now, the demo is available and carries over, and it's about 5 hours of content, which should last you the entire time.
Wow. Yep, so we're currently playing on PlayStation.
Yup.
Wow, the streets of Cornea. Castle Grand Corrine. Huh.
I beg you, my queen, take leave of this place while you're still able.
To where, I might ask? Nigh every last of Cornea's lords has forsaken us in favor of the traitor Valmore. No refuge remains for a crowned fugitive. Yet the general seeks my death and mine alone. I shall not flee from that fate. Though you still can, a sole rider with Elaine at your side. Take him, Joseph. Raise that delicate seedling into a sturdy tree capable of weathering the harsh climes that await. And pray safeguard the ring of the unicorn as well. Hold it close to you until Elaine is a man grown. He will have need of the power it bears.
My queen, I...
Mother? Are they coming for us?
Heed well these words, Elaine. I say this not as your mother, but as your queen. From here forth, you're to treat Joseph's command as though it were spoken directly with my tongue. Do you understand?
Of course, but is there something amiss?
My faith and more lies with you, Joseph. I only pray it is enough. Farewell, and may the heavens guide you.
Why are you just standing there, Joseph? Aren't you going to help her?
Would that I were able, my prince. Come, we've not a minute to spare.
So she's sending him away.
Yeah.
Hoping that
to live in exile until he's strong enough to potentially retake the crown. Ooh.
Oh, what did Valmore say?
I don't know. Bar the exits?
Our great general reduced to little more than a base traitor, You'll find my head not so easily parted from my shoulders, Valmore. I wonder if you can say the same.
There's a way to turn off auto text, probably in the settings.
Mm-hmm.
Come everyone, we march this day for Her Majesty Alinea.
And then they get small. Ooh, music's good. Move the cursor to select allied units, command them to move across the battle stage. Select Queen Alenia's unit and use the move command to make them march towards Velmar's position. Okay. How do I... Oh, there we go. I want to take a look at this. See if I can mess with these auto-advanced dialogue. Turn that off.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I could make it go longer.
Uh-huh.
But it's fine. Fast-forward and cutscenes we don't want. I'm going to crank some of these down a little bit preemptively so we can actually hear things better in cutscenes, because I think it was a little...
Yeah, the voice volume was a little bit low, but yep. That's fine.
Auto pause at the start of stage. Oh, so is this real-time-ish then?
Mm.
Interesting. I adored the combat system in 13 Sentinels, but it always felt a bit surface level. Oh, I can even save in the middle of a fight. I like how they're handling UI. It's very animated.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of moving parts. It feels good. Okay.
Yeah, and once again with the rings, she had the Ring of the Unicorn, which I suppose is their royal house?
We've no time to falter.
Okay, so we can loop around, engage in battle. I see.
Hmm.
So yeah, it is kind of real-time-ish. Okay, so we can organize, but I'm just going to do battle because I don't know what the heck I'm doing anyway.
Okay, so it looks like you might have a sorceress of some sort and a shield bearer.
So it looks like the combat is mostly automatic based on my formations.
Oh.
Behold my might. I trust you.
And once again, love how the characters are animated.
Yeah. It's kind of this like very interesting stiff illustrated style.
Well, it's I think it's animated 2D assets, so...
Yeah.
But you do have that three-dimensionality to it, depending on how they're turning, and yeah.
And it looks to be, they aren't even using spine. Maybe they are a little bit for, like, the standing motion, but that sorceress's, like, cloth is very much like a bunch of different frames
well,
there.
There's frames, but I think those are those bats underneath her?
Yeah, she's got a cloud of bats holding her up, which is so very stylish.
I wonder if you'll be flanked by that other group.
I don't know. My assumption is we're just going to get to Velmore and then lose. You know, we're going to clobber through his basic units.
I am your shield.
So yeah, you can also see like unit hit rates and stuff.
Does this suit you?
I'm assuming that Elaine, it is Elaine, right?
Alenia? I-L-E-N-I-A.
No, I'm talking about her son.
Oh.
I shall protect you.
You know,
that
I
forget. He's probably going to grow up and then have to retake together. The kingdom after it's already been conquered.
Yep. So maybe he has like kind of a weird fringe territory, or he acts as kind of a wandering mercenary at first, but gathers enough allies that it's like, now, you know, now we're strong enough, or maybe some other cause brings them back in.
My magic is yours.
Oh, so they had a limited amount of AP. So the gems underneath them is how many actions they can take, I think. I'm sure this will tutorialize more once we're actually in control of the boy.
We are
super hosed, but what else would we do? I mean, honestly, if I were in this situation, I'd be running around just killing as many of the trash mobs as possible. If I knew I was going to go down, I'd just decimate as much of their army as I can.
Well, why didn't you?
It didn't want me to.
Enlighten me, Velmor. To what end do you seek to usurp my throne?
I wish to be the unicorn.
Hey.
Self-centered fool. It's not merely your throne I aspire towards. It's all of them. Zenoira are the rightful sovereigns of Fevereth, and I the blade to restore our world to its natural order.
You seek to plunge the continent into war. Fevereth need not suffer your delusions.
A proper ruler demands unity, not pointless politicking with insufferable neighbors. Now, I shall achieve that unity through conquest and reclaim that which is rightfully mine.
I would sooner see you slain by my hand!
That guy's cloak,
y'all, he's very billowy. I like to imagine he's actually very tall, he just likes getting crouchy. One thing I note about a lot of, at least it was notable I think in Odin's Sphere, in this one there's kind of like an echo that is signature to their voice acting too, like they do some voice modulation.
Oh, well, I mean, this is happening in a great hall.
Yeah, but, like, I remember Odin's Sphere had kind of, like, a quality to it as well. I don't know if Dragon Crown did.
And yet our work only just begins. We stand now at a new dawn for Fevereth, one which will see Zenoira's dominion restored at last. Curious, though, that we've no trace of the old knight's captain.
About that, my lord. A lone cavalry unit was spotted riding through the eastern gate before it was barred.
And the boy is lost to us. A truth obscured only by his mother's futile attempt at a counter-offensive. It would seem I underestimated her penchant for deception.
Mm-hmm. So they know he lives. Well, that's a nice world map.
Aww.
Year 895 of the Hallowed Chronicle. Claiming himself a scion of the fallen Sonoiran Empire, Cornia's once decorated General Valmore rebelled against his erstwhile home at the seat of its monarchy, Gran Corinne. Its queen, Alenia, bold in the face of this staggering betrayal, stood unshrinking as the shield to her son Elaine's safe flight, and mustering what meager forces remained by her side, she rallied a defense as valorous as it was damned. With Cornia's queen lost, care of the young prince fell to her faithful knight, Joseph, who took wing beyond Valmore's wretched grasp to asylum on the Forned Isle of Palavia in the Holy Kingdom of Albion. And boastfully proclaiming himself Fevereth's new emperor, Valmore donned a second name, Calarius, and began a relentless onslaught the continent's nations could only but struggle against. Yet each realm's endeavors fell in vain time and again, and ere long Zenoira's vile dominion was realized. His blood-soaked unification come to bear. Few dared stand against the ironclad fist of Emperor Galerius. Embers of resistance burned on. Yet the downtrodden could cling only to furtive hopes of liberation. Desperate prayers which fell upon deaf ears, night after unceasing night. Ten years have passed since the Shroud of War first set over Cornia.
Unicorn ring. Oh, that's a pretty shrine.
It is.
Is that even the grave of the queen, or some?
I wonder if those two are at it again.
Might be.
Well, they wouldn't have even let her have
a proper monument, wouldn't.
Considering the invaders. But so this is Scarlet.
Well, that takes care of the altar. I suppose I should be getting back.
I mean, it's better than Dragon Crown. Yeah,
I
for context on that.
I saw a number of the characters in the opening, and I...
Vanillaware likes their ladies busty. But
many
not
of the
always.
Other ones were armored, and there was even an owl lady.
Ooh.
I'm looking forward to seeing. I mean, because they're.
Sorry, Elaine.
Oh.
This round's mine. Ah, you always were the optimist.
Oh, that's interesting. Are we going for the red Oni, blue Oni?
Yeah, except for, think? I guess our main character might be the blue Oni for once.
Yeah.
You got a good hit in. I'll give you that. There's just no stopping you these days. Yet you've grown no less than I have. Still, we could likely train for the rest of our lives, and even then, never manage to best Joseph.
Weird to think he's back on the mainland now. Finally making that Liberation Army thing a reality, huh? Guess that means we'll be going up against Anoira soon.
Indeed it does. The people of Cornea are suffering, Lex. Crying out for whatever help will hear their pleas. Should I turn a deaf ear to those voices, I would have little and less claim to the crown I feel is mine. That, and I owe it to my mother to see them safe.
Well, yeah, but... Zenoira's got the whole world in the palm of their hand. How are we gonna fight back against that?
The Earth may be theirs, but the heavens will surely favor those who stand for justice.
You got a point there. Sorry for not sounding all too confident. Just... make sure you don't take it all on yourself. I'll be with you every step of the way.
Thank you, Lex. You know I can't do this without you.
Oh, stop. You're gonna make me blush. Anyway, that's enough training for today. We're gonna miss lunch if we don't get moving.
I suppose it is that time.
You see something out there?
It's a ship.
Looks like they're flying Zenoira colors, too.
This island is no longer safe. We have to tell the others.
With you there. You head for the cathedral. I'll make sure the town knows what's coming.
I assume they're still on the religious
island. Yeah, probably.
But I thought it was Blavia. Conquered as well.
And do it quick! Not a soul gets off this island under our watch.
Hmm.
All soldiers have alighted, sir.
Wait, isn't that... is that the shield?
Yeah, that is the shield guy that was with the queen.
Do you think he was defeated and turned...
Dunno.
Dispatch the vanguard to the cathedral.
Or he was just a generic.
We're to apprehend the target alive.
This says Hodrick, though.
Yeah.
Was that the name?
Sir. I don't remember. It could be the same guy.
Oh, Heavenly Father, ruler of land and sky above, we pray this day for deliverance from evil. Grant us the meager sustenance to nourish our fragile bodies in the times to come. Guide our lost souls on the path to salvation. Shine down your radiant light upon us, for darkness looms thick through all corners of Fevrith. Such is my request as your humble servant. In the name of the Guardian Unicorn, and that of the Holy Mother. Is that you, Elaine? How many times must I ask you not to stomp around in the cathedral? What is the meaning of this?
Well, look what we've got here. Seems we're the first to show.
Rough her up if you want,
But don't forget, the girl dies and our heads will roll too.
Such depravity will not go unpunished. Not in the house of the Heavenly Father.
Yeah? Then you best get to praying.
She's fast.
Not as fast as us.
What the?
Scarlet, are you hurt?
Only a little shaken, that's all. What's happening to us, Elaine?
A ship has come ashore on Palavian soil. One hoisting the banner of the Zenoiran army.
And are they aware that you're the Crown Prince?
I can't say for certain, but we know one thing. These people are our enemy, and they must be stopped.
Yes. My cathedral will see no more bloodshed this day. Come, let's move outside.
Your Highness, it's a relief to see you unharmed.
Hold on. Where's Lex?
He went ahead to alert the town. We'd best find him and get to the harbor.
Indeed. But first, my prince, this belongs to you.
Ah, the ring.
A ring.
The ring of the unicorn. Queen Elenia wished for you to have it. In truth, I had intended to wait till signs of age played more deeply across your face. But we no longer have such luxury. I have the utmost faith you'll see it secured.
A keepsake from my mother. Thank you for this, Joseph. Truly.
Make no further mention of it. Now, let us be off.
Okay.
Battle stages.
Yeah, so allied and enemy units wage war in real time. Each battle stage's victory conditions must be fulfilled. Okay. Yeah, the real-time elements are interesting. Allied units can be deployed from a base with your flag. Move the cursor to command post, select deploy. Okay, so no stamina consumption, no wait time. Stage damage reduction, 50% steady HP recovery, stamina. So maybe this is like what we get for summoning units.
Mm-hmm. So currently we have Elaine's.
Yeah.
The day will be ours.
Deploying a unit consumes one valor point from the gauge on the upper left of the screen. It can be replenished by defeating enemies, liberating towns and fortresses, and more.
Elaine, look! They've already reached the town!
Then we know our first aim. We must dispatch those soldiers as quickly as possible. I will admit, this is kind of silly.
What?
I really wish that one of the main characters did not have a sword, like, of the two boys. When an allied unit encounters an enemy unit, battle menu will pop up on the screen. Organize your forces, view enemy details before battle, select battle once you're finished preparing. Do I even have much to... I don't know. I like it when main characters don't have swords. you know, give them a spear, an axe, or like a morning star. Because I know morning stars are like absolutely wicked in these. Whereas I know swords, especially once you start dealing with like actual full armor, swords actually drop off in usefulness. Because they're kind of just clubbish.
No, I know. It's just that, I mean, sword and board is still very effective.
I know. I don't know. I'm always like, ooh.
I'm curious, though, if she's a healer, perhaps? Or
so we can check.
Does she have holy
magic?
So
she's got holy light, attacks an enemy unit with magic, removes target's buffs. She's also got other moves that she hasn't learned yet. Quick heal, restore minor HP.
Okay,
so
after their hit. She is like a priestess. Oh, actually, that is her class. Yep. Priestess.
Yeah, so she also has regeneration and resurrection. I don't exactly know how many of these things trigger, and it doesn't really matter to me at the moment. Because I can't do anything about it. Gosh. See, flow of battles flow out automatically according to various predetermined rules. Initiative determines their order in battle. When they... their turn arrives, they will use one of their active skills. Using an active skill consumes AP.
Combatants will take turns using active skills in order according to their initiatives. Battle will continue until all combatants run out of AP. Passive skills will trigger automatically when certain conditions are met, such as being hit with an attack. First, Elaine's Noble Guard skill triggers when he's attacked, causing him to protect himself. Using a passive skill consumes PP, which is passive points. Next, Scarlet's Quick Heal skill triggers when an ally takes damage, thus healing that ally.
Easy now.
So is it more that the characters are programmed?
Yeah.
Finally, the enemy's Parting Blow skill triggers at the end of battle, performing an additional attack. The battle will end when all combatants have run out of AP, or when all combatants on one side have been defeated. You can also press the square button to view the battle log and review the skills.
We march on.
Okay.
Okay. Looks like they also maybe heal back up again, or no, that's their friendship.
If neither unit is defeated in battle, the side with the lower percentage of HP remaining is the loser. Upon losing a battle, the defeated unit is knocked back and enters a waiting state, rendering it immobile for a short period of time.
We almost have them. Just one more push.
We march.
Okay. So it looks like, yeah, his damage is left over. But there are character relationships that scale based on using them in battle.
Mm-hmm.
Engaging a waiting unit will grant the attacking unit a first strike. Unit executing a first strike will always act first, regardless of initiative.
Come then.
That's just the one guy in the back.
Oh yeah, because he fled.
But yeah, so auto battle mechanics, which, I mean, tracks. Very few tactical games from this era had like full manual battles. And of them, I kind of like the ones where it's automatic better. Good. All that remains now is to reclaim the town.
That's where Lex headed, right? I hope he's okay. Liberating facilities. Garrisoning a unit in a town, fort, or other facility will allow that unit to liberate the facility.
Okay. Move here.
To me.
I'm curious about how the real-time elements will work, if I'm really going to have to worry about heading enemies off. Probably.
Yeah, probably there are going to be multiple units on battlefields, and then you have to... Maybe you'll have multiple units of your own, too.
Yeah, that I have to constantly be, like, micromanaging a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so liberating facilities will replenish valor points and boost your score upon completing the stage. Additionally, facilities that have been liberated will serve as bases from which allied units can be deployed. Yeah, so you might actually have maps where there's different towns and things along the way, and you have to
take them all out,
attack
to
them,
new
fortify
footholds.
Them,
yeah,
heal up, move on. It almost reminds me of old school games where it's you're conquering cities.
Yep.
Not RTS style, but
more 4X, I guess.
4X, yeah. 4X.
Lex, hey, sorry about that. They caught me off guard there. But don't worry, everyone's safe. I made sure of it. I knew I was right to count on you, and I'm glad you're unharmed as well. Still wish I could have done more, though. Here, let me scout ahead and make up for it. Immediately dies.
Oh no, no, he wouldn't. That wouldn't happen.
Okay, Lex's unit, move here.
Sure thing.
So is there fog of war?
I'm not seeing it yet.
He's also alone, which is a little worrying.
Oh no.
Just what I was hoping for. It's time for time to show these guys what I'm made of.
All on his own?
Immediately dies.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it's one versus two. And they both hit pretty hard.
Got me good.
Yeah, I...
What was his plan?
Yeah, what was his plan? What was your plan?
Damn, might have gotten too eager there. Lex, no, we'll never make it in time. Allow me, your highness.
Ah, so this was scripted.
Yeah.
Okay. Unit mobility.
Yeah, so different units are faster than others, so...
He's on horseback?
Yep. So if I drop him there... Yep.
Awaiting your command.
Let's see, I can move to specified location. Can I just put him in front?
Maybe that will defend
him. Or no,
him.
He wants me to as move specifically to...
I am your foe this day. Prepare to be struck down.
Swapping positions.
Yeah, so we can swap them instead. Before battle, you'll see predictions of how much damage each unit will take, but they will change based on swapping units. Okay,
this
so
well.
Lex immediately dies, or...
Gaze upon the face of your demise.
I think we just wreck them, but I could be wrong. Yep. Nope. Not quite. Oh!
That?
He's got a passive to do a follow-up attack. Neat. And I like the unit designs. Like, yeah, some of them are a little bodacious, but the armor and clothing looks really nice.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's all rendered very well.
Lex, are you all right? Somehow, yeah. Sorry for making you worry.
You know, it's a miracle you can even put your armor on straight. Here, this medicine should perk you up again.
Acquired a healing tonic. Okay, HP. When a combatant's HP falls to zero, they're rendered incapacitated. Items and skills can restore HP and revive incapacitated combatants.
Hey, so we don't have to worry about permadeath, probably.
Yeah, select the items. Okay.
Something I always hated about some tactical games back in the day of, like, your character died forever, and it's like, oh, I don't like that. Phew, I needed that.
Chloe, perhaps you'd be better served watching after Lex directly. Fairy's a bit of a liability on his own.
Very much agreed. No more messing around, Lex. I'll be keeping a close eye on you.
Ah. Now then, the area appears to be safe for the time being. Let's hurry to the harbor.
My word, but that's Hodrick.
Yep, he recognizes him.
Yep, so it is the guy.
He and I used to stand as the stalwart pillars of Cornea's defense. What might possibly have changed him?
Probably the desire to live.
Prepare yourselves, rebels. Any foolish enough to defy Emperor Galerius must be put to the sword.
It seems combat's our only path forward.
Indeed. Ridding this land of the enemy must be our first and only priority, no matter who that enemy may be.
Defeat before the time limit expires. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Selecting multiple units. Move the cursor, while holding X to select multiple units, give them the same order at once. Just selecting the desired units. Okay.
Now, I do wonder, are you going to have strengths and weaknesses? Because some of them are having lances, others have axes.
I don't know if this does a weapon triangle.
Oh, okay.
So here's the question. Is there a way I can actually merge these groups?
It looks like you could have up to 6 people in a group, can't you?
Yeah, maybe not yet. Well, die, I suppose.
You get it.
Wait, no.
I shall hold.
You may have wanted to split them up.
Yeah. In retrospect, I shouldn't be using the knight much at all. I guess if I keep them all together, it won't matter. But he's level 20. This is definitely the trap back in the day. Like, I remember playing some other tactical RPGs, and you get the, like, really strong starting unit. You know, the seasoned commander or mentor character.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, they make the battle really easy if you use them.
What would you ask?
So they got knocked back. They retreated.
Yeah.
So the question is, do you continue pressing towards him or go for one of the healthy units?
Okay. I'm just going to stop here for a second. I'm just going to have a big ol' unit mosh for a bit. Mm-hmm. So what I can do here is I can swap who I'm using.
Your villainy ends here.
I wonder if I can swap who they're using. It doesn't look like it. It's fine. But since these guys are... Since Elaine... And
I mean, he can defend and attack, and then she has healing.
Yeah, so I'm probably gonna have him kind of up in front, because each of these enemies only does about 4 damage, and so she heals for 9. So even if he takes 2 hits during
the
fight,
where's your AP meter? Where's your AP meter?
It's little diamonds next to them. They show up kind of at the beginning of the battle, and then disappear.
Come then.
So if you notice on their health bars, they both have 1 red and 1 blue.
Oh, okay.
So, also, he's just going to be healing for 1. So sure. Yeah, I'm just gonna farm experience with Elaine for the time being. The reason why I wanted to put them all into one squad is because that just seemed more practical. Ooh, ouch.
Oh, they attacked her.
She healed herself, though.
Mm-hmm.
So keeping that in mind for Spear Boys.
Good.
That they actually have strike through. Okay.
Should you attack with any of the other groups?
I was going to go kill the spear guy.
Onward. Ready. You got it.
I'll not fail you.
Let's see.
By your word. I am yours to command, Your Highness.
You face me.
Let's see. So damage 17.
So that one guy is almost at full health.
Yeah.
Will you have enough HP for the final battle?
I think I'll be fine.
Light!
We march on!
Because yeah, I really want Elaine to get up to level 2 if I can get it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't necessarily know if it's going to work for him.
The time is at hand. To me.
The time limit doesn't seem
your
to be commencing.
It's gone down a little bit. But we're kind of clobbering them. I'll just go for one more. I don't know if they're active or not. No, they're just being slow. Ooh.
Ooh, he's definitely tanky in comparison.
Well.
Oh. Well, magic.
Was tanky.
Magic just for the win.
So, the letters, by the way, next to their stats, mm-hmm. I believe that is the chances in which they will increase. So if you have an A ranking for guard rate, it's most—it's more likely to go up than something that, say, is a C or a B.
Interesting. And is that based on what they utilized in battle?
No, I think it's actually just based on their base stats. So, for example, she's not very good at crit or guard, but her magic defense is going to be very high.
A fine bout.
And sometimes you can actually modify those, maybe. Okay, let's sure actually thing. Use these two briefly.
Mm-hmm.
On it.
Well, yeah. Well, now it's the two of them together as well.
Come then.
Okay, so let's swap.
This one's mine.
Let's finish these guys off. Because, yeah, I want to get...
Oh, long thrust. Wow, that was good.
Yep. I want to get these two up, but I want to have my heal tank combo. Oh, they grow faster? Or maybe it's because they got a kill. Okay. Let's move in. So they're going to do some damage.
But you might be taking turns with each of your groups?
Yeah, that's kind of where I'm at.
What would you
ask? Except for him. He's just going to be there if we're in dire straits. Like if we lose.
I have arrived.
Mm-hmm.
It's not looking great.
Okay.
Oh, so you're going to sustain some damage.
I think I'm going to put him in first.
Mm-hmm.
Because I want to clear the frontliner.
Yeah.
This struggle will only prolong the pain. Accept the mercy of a swift demise.
Why are you doing this? You, who once stood as my mother's royal guard.
Enough of your questions, whelp. Interfere, and I shall see you suffer for it. I'll guard you.
I would have thought he... It would have been wise for him to keep his identity a secret. Unless it's difficult to...
I think it's
to
probably too late. They knew he existed somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
all buffs removed? Yep.
Yeah, I guess the dude's got really high physical defense, but...
Magic less so.
Yeah.
My legs grow heavy.
No, I refuse to cease just yet. Such firm defenses. Our weapons barely leave a scratch.
Perhaps my magic will work then. Leave this to me, Elaine.
Okay, fast forward to advance time quickly. Can be used in both stages during, in both in stages and during battles. The game's pause, fast forwarding will automatically resume it.
March.
Oh, he's trying to heal.
To me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm up.
None of that, you.
On it. This one's mine.
Okay.
So yeah, he'll sustain some damage, but
yeah. So we're just gonna bounce off this guy a bunch.
Mm-hmm.
There's only so much I can do about that. And long thrust might hit both of them? Alas, no. Oh, but he can only guard the first guy. So that's actually kind of useful. Rude.
Ouch. Ah, but she does have first aid on her.
That's how it's done.
Okay. And yeah, I don't really see there being a reason not to do this. Die!
You won't touch them.
It's true. Oh, he does have a self-heal of some variety when he hits an enemy.
Well, yep. There he goes.
He's down for the count. Really only 8 experience. I guess it's because the whole enemy group has to be felled.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's not gone permanently, even though he's the boss.
Yeah, so once we take out the remaining dude. And we can speed through this.
Oh, you have a little fast forward button of some sort?
Yeah, it works both in battle and out of battle. So that's why they got a bunch of experience for that. And he's got an S-rate guard, but the rest of his stats are kind of eh.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if I can modify those.
Oh, now you've claimed it.
Cool.
Stage clear.
It would amuse me to no end if we had, like, different rankings, like superlative. Like, you are now the unicorn novice.
So you got some honors, war funds, and renown. I wonder if over the course of this you're going to be, I mean, liberating much of the world.
Is this?
I'm assuming so. I wonder if it's got more kingdom management or if it's just pure mission-based.
Oh, do you know what would be really interesting?
Yeah?
Okay, so thinking about war campaigns, imagine if you've liberated a number of towns, but then you have advancing armies at different locations and you have to decide who you're going to support tactfully.
I bet that's actually going to be a thing we have to worry about, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
One such as I, brought low by the corneate vermin that gnawed our ankles. You've fallen far indeed, Hodrick. How many times did you stare death in the face at Her Majesty's side? Now, look what you've become. I may stand as your swordmaster no longer, but I can yet offer you a merciful end to your Wait!
Oops.
Descend. Yep.
Your Highness.
Tell me, Hodrick. Do you remember the times you and I played together? When I was still just a boy? Yours was a bond of loyalty few knights could hope to equal. Why cast that aside and bend the knee to Galerius? I refuse to cut down a friend without first knowing how we've reached this grim conclusion. A simple reason is all I ask. Please.
Elaine!
The ring! What sorcery is this?
It was mind control.
My head.
Yeah, you're right. It's mind control. What?
What am I doing here?
A spell to shackle the hearts of men.
'Tis the only way I can think to describe it, my prince.
It absolves him of all wrongdoing.
We get to the Emperor and he too has been ensorcelled. Nobody was the bad guy.
Oh, it was just the wizard all along. I don't know about that.
I want a category. Like,
well, okay, so the thing is,
we should almost put a list together where it's just, like, just a bunch of columns for, like, you know, it was the wizard all along. Because I can definitely think of at least 2 different games.
The evil vizier.
Where it's, like, yeah, only the evil wizard was at fault and everything else was just, like, just dumb luck and some bad choices.
Well, the thing is, they said that wasn't the guy a renowned general?
Yeah.
Or Cornea? What could have possibly changed him?
What could have changed his mind? I mean, yeah. He could have been lying in wait. He could have found the Nega Unicorn Ring, and that's how he's...
Ah, the evil unicorn ring. Okay, well, we'll see. In any case, Hodrick is back to himself.
That ill-fated day, all the lords closest to your mother turned upon her without so much as a moment's notice. Unfortunately, my memories end there as well. A frightful power, if what you say is true. This spell of control, it could be called. Such magic would go far in explaining how Galerius so swiftly brought Fevrith to its knees.
I shudder to think what unspeakable evil I wrought upon our world these last 10 years. Though there is no greater misdeed than turning my spear upon you, Prince Elaine.
That's enough. You mustn't blame yourself any further. But I do wonder, how is this ring capable of unmaking the spell?
In truth, I had believed it to be mere regalia, a symbol of your birthright and nothing more. To think the power of cleansing truly exists. Your Highness, that is the Ring of the Unicorn, ancestral treasure of Cornia's royal lineage.
I mean, unicorns are known to be healers, right?
Yep.
What?
There's that one book series you told me about. Oh. Where you couldn't ride the unicorn unless you were...
I mean, you can't touch them unless you're a virgin, yeah.
I just... Sorry. Just...
But don't... What? You're thinking about unicorn powers and unicorn rings?
I can't help it. You
okay.
Broke my brain with that years ago, and now it's like the only thing I can think about.
Now all you need is an actual talking unicorn.
They're just narwhals. Like, everybody got it wrong. Turns out,
I mean, they used to sell narwhal horns as unicorn horns back in the olden days.
They're teeth. That always amuses me.
Yep, they are teeth.
Legend speaks of your ancestors wielding it to purify evil. But I had believed such tales to be mere fiction.
The Orthodoxy has a similar story about the Holy Unicorn. How it was a sacred beast able to purge darkness from our lands. It's entirely possible that the ring that bears its image is somehow capable of that same power.
Should Galerius's rule be built upon a foul sorcery that fetters our people, then this ring is the ray of light that will pierce its wicked heart.
Your words ring true, my prince.
Indeed. Were we able to free those bound by his cruel magics?
It might just bring the iron wall of Zenoira crashing down.
All told, I've often found myself plagued with doubt. Is it justice that guides our march, or paltry vendetta? Yet the answer is clear as day now. The path before us is laid bare, and all that remains now is to walk it. Walk it I will, Mother. Today marks our first foray into the mists of despair which hang heavy over our home. Mists that will soon be dispelled. It may take days, months, or even years, but I shall see the duties of my bloodline fulfilled, and slay Galerius like the beast he is.
Though it would be a shame if he meets Galerius and once again the ring purifies
and
him.
How
you
does
go,
Hodrick fare?
Who do I blame now? Oh, how does Hodrick fare? Okay.
Well, all things considered, any fog that lingered in his mind seems to have cleared, and he stands ready to fight once more. By the way, Your Highness, allow me to brief you on our plans for when we arrive. Among the Liberation members I've mustered in my past excursions is a young yet skilled knight by the name of Clive. I'll ride to bring him to you the moment we reach solid ground.
You have my thanks.
A word, Elaine?
Is something wrong?
Well... No, it's nothing.
Are you sure? Anxiety will be the death of you if you keep it bottled up like that.
It really isn't important, I assure you. It's just... Our lives have changed so drastically from the peace we had only yesterday. It barely seems real.
I can't say I feel any different. But I've always known this day would come. It's why I've spent all these years training under Joseph's careful instruction. A shame you never had the chance to meet my mother. She was always one to blaze a path forward, royal blade in arm. But as her heir, I intend to lead in much the same way.
Is that why you and Lex spent all your days banging swords down at the shore?
You've seen that, have you? You know, Hodrick was likely but one of many. And assuming the others who surrendered to Zenoira are being controlled as he was, we may just stand a chance in this. Yet our liberation is still in its nascent days. Promising, yes, but gravely fragile as well. Which is precisely why I'll need your help, Scarlet. To reclaim peace for all who have suffered.
Elaine, I... Of course. I'll do everything I can. As is my role as a priestess of the Palladian Church.
Hey, don't forget about me!
Lex!
What?
I'm sorry, my prince. Decorum doesn't come naturally to this fool.
It's all right. When you've known each other as long as we have, there's no reason to let formality bind us.
I like her scale mail.
But there are protocols to observe. Rules we must follow as vassals in service of the crown.
Yeah, it glitters when she...
I hadn't processed that yet.
Mm-hmm.
That's also just kind of a nice way of handling it for scale mail. It's just a bunch of hexagons, but...
Well, because there's chain mail and then there's scale mail. And I think the scale mail is when you have...
It's a bunch
of
small
metal.
Metal diamonds, generally, that are stitched together with chainmail underneath.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think anybody's got chainmail on. Unless that's supposed to be chainmail around her neck.
Yeah, and the thing is, Elaine doesn't have anything.
No.
Under his armor. I don't think Lex...
His unprotected shoulders worry me.
Yeah, the shoulder your shoulder is one of the things you want to protect most because it's your whole arm.
Your shoulder and your neck.
Like
that boy's armor is going to get him disarmed or beheaded.
Still, I'm of the same mind. What mind he has, that is. I'll give my all in the royal name, Your Majesty.
Thank you all. I couldn't ask for a finer group of friends.
Thighs are another really important one.
Yes.
Save your progress. Wait, what do you mean? About where to place armor? Or what?
No, just the phrase thick thighs save lives popped into my mind.
No.
Ah. We'll just do tactical.
Oh, so they have story, tactical, and what is it? Like difficult?
Expert.
Lore? Expert.
Call and you can action. Switch it at any point, which is nice.
Off Rear Harbor.
Elaine, why have you stopped?
Hodrick has become blue.
Mm-hmm.
We're surrounded.
Not the welcome party I was hoping for.
Oh, the poor horses.
Get your vile claws off of me! Let her go!
Chloe! I should have known you'd be behind this treachery, Renault.
What is the meaning of this?
Apologies for the icy reception, but we've business with the girl.
What business could you have with Scarlet? Unhand her this instant.
No, I don't think that will be happening. I act under orders from Emperor Galerius himself. As for what he plans to do with her, that's not for one of my station to know.
He was the knight in the Queen's party as well.
Oh, really?
I think he was, yeah.
Well, there was a guy with a beard.
Yeah, he was behind. He had a spear, but he was standing. But there was a dude on a horse, a dude with a shield, a sorceress, a just regular spearman, and then the queen herself. It was a party of five.
Maybe they will be the villains that we face. I mean, we've already faced Hodrick.
I hope at least one or two of them weren't mind-controlled, just so we actually have a villain to fight.
Mm-hmm.
Yet I shall see it done all the same.
No! Scarlet!
All
My work here is concluded. I leave the rest to you and your capable band.
Don't worry, boss. I'll earn my keep and plenty more.
Straight into the hornet's nest, huh? You gotta do something, Elaine.
Hear me, soldiers of Cornea. I ask that you stand aside for your returned prince.
Sorry, kid. Can't do that. It's nothing personal. Just following orders from the guy paying the coin.
Damn, we have no hope of overcoming such numbers.
Ah, there's Joseph.
Your Highness. With us, everyone, I beg you. Come, my prince.
Oh, so that's Clive. All right. So we have another
knight. I'm ashamed to hear you met such misfortune before I arrived.
Your Highness, this man is Clive, the knight we spoke of earlier.
A pleasure.
Still, it rankles the mind. I never would have dreamt that Galerius was after Scarlet, and not you, my prince.
I love these environments.
They're very well painted.
Well, and what I love about this, too, is, so you have the characters in their, you know, 2D battles, but then you can use the same characters in all the cutscenes, too.
Yeah. Yeah, it's got that the characters are defined enough that you can have a nice zoomed-in version.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it looks, I don't know, it you are
I just
correct.
Also really
it just
like,
looks really nice.
Well, I also really enjoy, too, that the flames from the candles and the fire, it actually, I don't think it reflects on the characters in this particular scene. I know that depending on the lighting, it does elsewhere.
Yeah.
But just the fact that you have this glow in the objects and the environment, it's just, I don't know, very well handled. I really like this.
Who was that knight who took her?
His name is Renaud, formerly a proud servant of Queen Elenia, not unlike myself. And just as I fell victim to Galerius and his foul magic, it would seem he has met with a similar fate.
All the same, why Scarlet? Perhaps her role as a priestess has something to do with it.
Mm-hmm. I would say magic in general, perhaps.
Lately I've heard tell of Zenoira's desire to spread its roots into the Orthodoxy, making one with direct ties a prime target. In any case, the risk to her safety is clear should she fall into Galerius's hands. And sitting idly by only serves to stoke my worry further. Let us be off at once.
Wouldn't do that if I was you. No chance you're helping the girl if you don't even know where you're going.
And you are? Don't worry, he's a friend. A collaborator of mine by the name of Travis.
Fancy way to refer to a spy. You need intel, dirt, or just the latest weather, I'm your man.
And what of Renaud?
Rode east, faster than a clap of thunder. I can only assume he's going for the city. But the real problem is his army of mercenaries. We won't after Renaud. We've got to go through them.
Your Highness, we all share your sense of urgency, but we've no hope of aiding Scarlet without first routing the enemy before us.
Right. We depart as soon as we're able.
So that fortress over there serves as the enemy command post.
Indeed, Your Highness, and the region will not know peace until we claim it as our own.
Housecarls are excellent attackers who can lower enemies' defense to do heavy damage.
As for us, this fortress here is our first and final line of defense. The enemy overruns us, we'll have nowhere else to run.
Housecarls? Does that literally mean housemen?
Probably.
Then we defend it at any cost and proceed forth with extreme caution.
Okay.
Defeat Albin. The one problem is we don't have our team healer anymore.
Wanderwood, no.
Forgive the intrusion, Your Highness, but I believe our units will struggle without the proper changes to their formations. Okay, so we can adjust formations.
Oh, nice. Okay. Now that you have enough units.
Add,
for
swap,
it.
Or remove members of a current unit. Let's see. Oh, explain the strengths of each class type first. Let's see. Class is a set, or, yeah.
Yeah, what weapon and skills they're able to use as well. Okay.
Okay.
Interesting.
Okay.
So, do you want to make two units or one unit? Or, wait, there's currently three units.
Oh, I see. You can only have two members currently.
You can only have two per squad at the moment?
Yeah. I'll probably do that for now.
Okay. And where are you going to put the thief?
What level is Hodrick, too? I'll probably do that for now. So, a hoplite and a thief?
But what about Joseph?
You know, I don't want him.
Is it because he's already at a high level?
Yeah,
or?
Because Joseph is level 20, using him in battle actively is going to hold everybody else back.
Oh, everyone else is only level 2. I'm surprised Hodrick doesn't have a higher level considering his age and the fact that he was an equal of Joseph.
Maybe he's
almost
weakened. Maybe, I don't know.
Maybe it's the 10 years having been mind controlled. Yeah, I understand.
But so
Travis is only one level higher. Wait, no.
He's
the same level. Okay, so what's one? Oh, those
are the
units.
These are the squads they're in.
Ah.
Yeah. And so, unless I absolutely need to, I think I'm going to try and avoid using Joseph because it's just not going to work out well for me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So we're going to deploy probably a lane. Since he has self-healing on his own. Let's see. Let's have Lex.
They will know what hit them.
Is Chloe still available?
Yeah.
Okay.
Chloe's with him.
Because she had, at least she was able to use potions for healing as well.
Onward.
Okay, there we go.
Yeah, those are all the mercenary groups.
And I think I can your heal at a camp here just by hanging out. Whoa, look at that damage. There we go. Sit up in my chair. And we still have plenty of healing items. Yeah, Vanillaware has always had absolutely gorgeous backgrounds. Like, I don't want to say their reliance on 2D. Their chosen style of 2D assets that they've stuck with for so long has been so nice.
And they've also mixed some 3D in, but it's very subtle.
Yeah, it's very subtle.
For instance, when Scarlet was twirling her staff before, I believe the staff itself was 3D.
I wouldn't be surprised by that. But these were the, well, I mean, this was the studio that was still making 2D games back when everybody else was making the switch to 3D. And so I think it always lent them a bit of a cult hit status as opposed to like massive success. But I think now that times have changed and people are like, oh yeah, 2D is actually really good. I think hopefully people are warming up specifically to the idea of games like this.
And also, I can tell that they're definitely using the 2D animated techniques that you would have if you ever wanted to animate your own paintings, for instance.
Yes.
The time is at hand.
Cutting out all the pieces. I think there's a little bit of like skew and stretch sometimes, but then also layering.
You got it.
Yeah. Now, do they have reinforcements? I want to see what waiting does.
No? Oh, they're resting.
Yeah. I just wanted to see what it would do. Nope. No idea.
I'm up.
There we go.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so I should probably use Lex. Oh. Damn it. Looks like they've got the guys crawling all over the harbor. And judging by appearances, I suspect they have more units ready to join the battle at any moment.
Facilities controlled by the enemy army will occasionally call reinforcements to the battle.
So,
try attacking the enemy controlling the facility if you want to stem the tide. This will force them to heal, stopping them from summoning reinforcements.
Ah.
So, if you take over the port, then you don't run the risk of having them heal again and outflank you.
You face me.
The only kind of downside on that one is sometimes
they
you
could
do
be
want
powerful.
Those. Well, no, it's, not really. These guys aren't any stronger. It's not like they get a fortification bonus for being based out of the harbor at the moment. The main one is just that.
Well, so going back to our analogy to 4X, for instance.
Yes.
I found that sometimes there were instances where you would attack a city or a fortress, and you didn't know how many units were hiding inside it. So you could come in with a big force, and they would send out one unit, and then they could send out more units, and then they could send out the next.
Yeah. Okay. Avoid using only a single unit in battle. Yeah, so...
So their stamina be exhausted.
Yep. Resting unit is defenseless. And won't be able to... Oh, gosh. Won't even be able to do anything about that.
To me.
Okay, so let's garrison them.
Sure thing.
Go take these guys out. Or try.
See, we're able to reclaim the harbor.
Yep. And it looks like we will heal as long as we're garrisoned.
Oh, kind sir. Thank you for saving us. I hope this can prove useful in the battles ahead.
Revival orb.
You got revival orbs.
Huh. The bridge there appears to be held by enemy spear bearers. Not only are they capable of delivering piercing attacks to an entire column, but they deal heavy damage to cavalry as well.
Ooh.
Suggest you exercise the utmost caution in handling them, my prince.
So you don't want cavalry or people in line.
Ah.
So you can stagger them.
Instead. So that is actually useful. Fine reminder, Clive. Let's consider well the enemy's strengths before marching into battle.
So you can adjust everything before attacking them?
Yeah. Do loadout? Edit? No.
Or do you have to go to your screen? Or can you only do that elsewhere?
It's not stage menu. Oh, reposition. There we go.
Ah, there you are.
Ready.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so while Elaine and Clive heal.
They can rest.
Yeah, yeah, I'll have these two kind of roll in and fight.
Oh, look, they have a bridge as a prop. That's nice.
Yeah. I'm quite curious how many different backgrounds they have. Though, I think they've reused, like, the grass, for example.
Maybe grass and trees and whatnot.
I think that rune at the top. Like, some of this I've definitely seen.
Mm-hmm.
In their lineup. Let's see. Where'd they go? Oh, nope. There they are.
I'm up. You got it.
They were knocked back briefly, but they're just going to keep coming for these guys. I don't know why they got knocked back. These guys got messed up and we took no damage. I guess maybe just that they're fortified and we're not. Now, does she still do a first aid? She does.
Yep.
And that might not even be a, Oh. Kids aren't half bad. Come on, boys. It's time we teach them what they're up against.
Oh, so they're actually sending units out.
There are more of them? You gotta be kidding me. Alas, it's no joke. I suggest we stand our ground and await their advance rather than charge blindly forward. Okay, so we have garrison effects.
Oh, so you probably want to claim the bridge.
Yep. So you do actually get a bonus. Okay, we can now skip battles by pressing start.
But it's better to watch them how they play out, yeah?
It's mostly for just learning.
Yep.
I know there are some games where the auto-calculate is, like, actually kind of jank. Okay, so I'm just going to have them hang out there. Let's see. So what's the benefit here? Resist ranged assist. Less damage from ranged attacks. I want to take a look at the bridge. Oh, no stamina consumption, no wait time.
Mm.
So we can just kind of chill. I guess actually, we have...
Oh, you still have the other group.
Yeah, hold up. Can I actually deploy them from here? Yeah, deploy. We're going to bring out Hodrick's unit. Arms. Might as well get them some experience.
Mm-hmm.
At once.
This one's mine.
Okay. But yeah, we'll just have these two hang out on the bridge and fight. Considering she seems to just heal, just at the end of every fight, so it's actually very valuable.
Oh,
for...
and they were put in a row, so she was able to damage both of them.
I think she's been doing that to most of the infantry groups they've been up against. So yeah, I'm just gonna have them hang out there. They'll be fine or something.
I'm ready to hit something.
And if I can somehow
beef his... I love how he leaps into battle.
Yeah.
Very graceful.
No, this is, as somebody that grew up with tactical RPGs, is like my primary game of choice. This very much is probably one that would have eaten up a significant amount of time when I was in middle school. Let's see. We're just gonna, you know, yeah, I'm just gonna fast forward. Let's see how these guys fare in battle. Worst comes to worst, I bring them back and have them heal. I just want to get them some experience and also just see how they fight.
Oh yeah, because we haven't seen the thief fight. Oh, and he's gonna defend. But he has evasion.
Yep.
That was a cool backflip.
Oh, so evade costs a passive.
Hmm. So the passive crystals are the blue ones, and then the red crystals are the
actives.
AP.
Yep.
Okay. That's a great way of handling it. So I assume the passive skill for a defender would be blocking.
Yeah, which is why you only guarded for one of the two one of the two hits. And I'm sure as they level up, they get extra active and passive slots. You can even see right here. See how it has four potential? I don't know what levels you unlock those, but it probably isn't very often.
That's a great way to handle attack and defense. Having them be limited resources.
Yeah. Yeah, it makes sense. I guess I was kind of trying to talk about this earlier, but he gets two extra passives for those hits. That's why he's got two dodges. But yeah, I adore tactical RPGs, specifically where I'm not managing them in like the direct fights. And so having this kind of system where it's more about how I've composed and built my characters.
Yeah, you're not controlling every move or every ability.
Yeah, and so it's more of just like, hey, this group works together and is very strong at this specific combo. So these two are pretty tough to kill, because she'll just keep healing and back up again.
Mm-hmm.
See, Chloe?
Ouch. Only his HP went up by one. That's rough. I know back in the day, the trick would be for that one to save scum. If you don't get the HP you want, you would actually just like reload and do that as many times as you needed to. Because it was randomly generated. These runes may hold something of use. And find items by garrisoning in runes. Well, we should have just enough to fight, kill these guys, and then possibly take the runes from them. Oh, passive steal. Oh no, he's stealing passives from...
That's how you can get more evasion.
Yeah, so he's literally stealing their...
their gems.
Yeah.
Have they finished healing? Or they're doing that now?
Yeah, okay. I think they just finished there. To be rust on my spear. So I might actually have to bring these guys back, because...
Was that... your blood will be rust upon my spear, or you will be rust?
I think it might be your blood will be rust upon my spear. Okay, they only have enough stamina for maybe one more of those. I'm just gonna head down here. I guess I'm just gonna head here for the time being.
Onward.
Let's see. Because yeah, they might run out of stamina.
You're gonna have the roundabout way to the one camp with the Aubyn.
Well, I want to take out as many unit groups as possible.
Now we're in the ruins.
In the ruins, this creepy gargoyle-looking thing.
Well, didn't you notice that the villains had... it almost seemed akin to demons as their insignia.
Could be.
A victory for the liberation.
A moment, please.
Because then we also had the unicorns and maybe lions.
They can't even move when they're out of stamina. Well, that's fine.
Well, I mean, they're tired.
Yeah.
Are you sure you don't want to claim the ruins for yourself on the way down, or no?
I'm going to have them do it.
So, what next? Sure thing.
And I might as well withdraw a unit. No, we'll just have them wait. We don't have any,
Oh, there's another unit going there.
Good.
That's fine.
We march.
So long as you can reclaim the bridge, you don't want them to claim it from you.
Your orders, my liege. Received.
I'm up.
I have claimed it as our own.
Do you think they're going to get the bridge
they
before
might.
You're done
the
healing?
Bridge doesn't. The bridge really doesn't make that much of a difference. Oh, they're fine.
On it. Your villainy.
So the bridge's primary benefit is that it.
I mean, it would be a tactical advantage.
No, it makes it so you don't cost stamina to fight, which is
great for defending.
That's why we're taking damage here. Because I still have them lined up.
Wait, you have them lined up? Why?
Because I'm a goofus and I forgot.
We march on.
Ouch.
Another step forth.
Should remedy that.
Yeah.
Post haste.
The path is set.
Okay. Yeah, and they weren't even going for the bridge. They were going for the next one. But that's fine. Get wrecked, suckers. Oh, it's just this one guy.
Are you okay? That's how it's
done. I might use these two to take on the ends. They seem pretty capable.
Sure thing.
At this point, if they have enough stamina, you might want to move them on, but are you going to be doing a pincer move with two of your groups? I think you shouldn't tackle him until you have at least two of the three groups there.
Yeah.
You got it. I'm up.
Okay, I'm just going to garrison them on the bridge.
But remember, that place might keep spewing out enemies until you defeat it.
And that's kind of fine, actually.
All done.
How can I proceed? Can't have them do anything.
Did they acquire the items from the ruins yet?
Oh, Dew of Strength. Ooh. Increases target's physical attack power by one. That is useful. And I could use a healing thing if I really wanted to. So how would these guys?
Ooh. Well, you're still in a row, too. You need to fix your composition there.
Yeah.
We march.
Okay, so how would they do now? Still not great. Definitely better. I think I'm just gonna go back to the harbor.
All the way?
There is time yet to claim victory.
Might have to use an item.
Okay, so did you get what you need from the ruins? Was it the potion bottle?
I think it was that strength item.
The strength dew?
Yeah.
Good.
Okay, and then I'll have to have all three more or less charge, and we'll just, if I have to use items, I'll have to use items. Because, yeah, we have the time limit.
Healing.
Score one for Lex. Told you I'm
oh, yeah, you're already past halfway.
Yep.
Ready.
So it's go time. It's a set rally point.
You got it.
Maybe that's where everyone meets?
No idea. Maybe.
Received.
Let's see. That'll have to do.
Onward.
Yeah, so the time limit ensures that you don't delay indefinitely.
That there's Aubin, leader of the mercenaries. Don't let your guard down for even a second. Okay. Relative strength of the unit.
3-star rating as the commander.
Okay.
Consider saving at critical moments.
Oh, good. We can save scum.
I mean, it makes sense to be able to save right before a boss battle.
Yeah. I'm just now thinking of the, like, well, I could save right before,
sure thing.
Right before character levels, and why is it 44?
Ooh. And you're sure this is an instance you want to, well, no, Joseph is level 20. Even this Aubin guy is level 3.
On it.
Yeah, shouldn't be that much of an issue.
So, what next?
How shall I proceed?
Okay, what about these two?
And you can only have two people per unit?
Once.
I've arrived. The time is at hand.
Because you could have two units of three people.
No, I cannot.
You can't?
No.
Not yet?
We march.
Okay.
The path is set.
Okay, before he summons anybody, this is going to hurt.
Mm-hmm.
Well, look who finally came knocking.
Apologies, but I fear we lack the time for pleasantries.
Figures. Let's get it over with then.
Ow.
That explains things.
Ow. Was his initiative just low?
You're done for. You okay?
Oh, and he heals?
Yeah, the spear guys have heals. At least Clive levels up.
I'll not let this go to waste.
Not really the stat up I was hoping for, though.
He's even stronger than he looks. Can we truly defeat such a powerful opponent?
We can indeed. Our morale alone should be more than enough to see us through. Ah, we can use valor skills. That explains things.
Different classes have access to different valor skills.
Okay. Grants units first strike to allied units in range, which is useful. Okay.
Merely a bit of pain.
Valor skills. So, increased damage dealt by 20%, reduced damage taken by 20%, and first strike to all allied units within range. Experience earned for a battle, or damage units in a designated range.
What?
Interesting. Reduced damage probably because of that. So let's do Valorous Order. And I think that works for every single one of them for one battle. What do these guys have? Fortress. Negate damage suffered by an allied unit or steal gold from an enemy. Yoink! That's a decent amount of money.
600 for the war funds, but it probably uses up time, doesn't it? Unless everything's paused at the moment.
It's currently paused at the moment.
Ooh, life aid. Revive incapacitated members.
Can I do this?
You're not healing them.
No, I'm not.
What are you doing?
Oh, ineffective versus garrison units. Didn't work.
They can't leave their garrison.
Yeah.
Right.
How shall I proceed?
Can you use items to heal up the prince?
Yeah.
Okay, that's pretty good.
And you know what? I might as well use the Dew of Strength. If there's one character that could use it.
I'm up.
Okay, can they do anything?
They're going to take a lot of damage in the process.
Yeah, we have one healing item. The main thing is we still kind of have to.
How about the shield guy?
Oh, hey, there's some damage.
To me.
See, I'm just going to charge him and we'll just see what happens.
Time grows short. This isn't good.
The enemy is.
Start with these
two.
Yep.
Because main goal is to take out one of the spearmen.
Not looking great. Mm-hmm.
Too bad they don't concentrate on one enemy as opposed to.
Yeah.
Maybe it's whoever's in their lane.
Yeah. Okay, next up.
It's not looking great.
Do I want to do that? Unit detail. You know what? This is fine. Just.
She's going to attack that guy, hopefully.
Yeah, there we go. There's one of the two.
Yeah, he's just going to lose half his health. Or everything.
A little bit more. I mostly just wanted to take out that one guy. Because if I can do that, I can take out the other one.
Hey, critical.
Good crit.
Oh, that took off most of his health.
We might actually take him out.
Oh, but
nope, never mind.
He was incapacitated.
Yeah, it's fine.
Fine job.
Let's see.
'Tis merely a bit of pain. Onward.
What happened to your last group? They're hanging back, correct?
Yep. We have one more. I guess here's the question. I can kill him. Okay, so in that case, we want to do Royal Order on self.
Stronger than ever. The time is at hand.
Okay, so what that's going to do is double the experience we gain for hopefully killing the boss.
Mm-hmm. Which would probably render you an amount of XP in general. Yeah, the thing about his slashes is they incapacitate. Oh, but gone.
Yeah, it didn't matter.
Good.
Ooh, I made the correct decision there. Look at all that experience.
Yeah, they're up to level 4.
On my honor as a knight.
Those are some good levels, too.
Victory grows ever closer.
And we get a Vitality Talisman, yep. Which is actually really good.
And you got a Command Pose.
Well, that doesn't matter as much now. Battle's over.
Mm-hmm.
So, Renown Rank E? Oh, it scales our reward.
Excellent.
It's a multiplier based on how renowned we are. So, didn't do so great time-wise, but I don't really care. Maybe. I guess it does determine somewhat what our bonuses are. I wonder if I can redo levels.
Alone, are you? What happened to your friends?
Long gone by now. But with all the time about them, never could have done without you lot chasing me halfway to hell and back, though.
The fort's empty, Your Majesty. Not a soul in sight.
Guy laid out the bait, and we just had to take a nibble. Strange. Few leaders would play the sacrificial lamb in such a predicament.
Don't flatter yourselves. I would have shook you off like weak old mud if I hadn't hurt my leg in our little scuffle. But hey, that's just part of the job. You're gambling with your life the second you take that coin.
Then you know how this ends. Stay your blade, Lex. There's something I need to ask him. What does Galerius want with Scarlet? I'll take any scraps of information you may have, please.
You do realize I'm just hired steel, yeah? They keep my pockets nice and heavy, and that's as far as my curiosity goes. So, sorry, but I'm not a questions kind of guy. At least not past my bottom line.
Well, what do we do with him?
Hire him.
Let's say I offered to fill those pockets instead.
Mm-hmm.
What then?
First, I'd ask if you still had all your marbles, but I'm not the discriminating type. As long as the pay is right.
If this is supposed to be a joke, I'm not laughing. We're trying to beat the enemy, not hire them. It's not every day you come across a man willing to greet the heavens in order to see his allies safe. Now, our aim is to liberate these lands from the oppressive clutches of Zenoira and its emperor. I'd ask your aid in that battle.
You know, I had heard you were nothing more than the crumbs of some spineless resistance that got chewed up and spat back out. Never would have guessed you're really just a pack of reckless lunatics.
This so-called lunatic is none other than Prince Elaine, true-born heir to the Cornian throne. And our war is a righteous one.
You're trotting around the crown brat of a dead and gone kingdom trying to flip a whole damn empire? Sorry, kids, but I don't like them odds.
Doesn't sound like he's interested.
Hope you know I don't come cheap.
Does that mean you'll join us?
Granted, you're willing to foot the bill. King making's not an everyday job for a merc. But you've seen enough to know I'm worth the gold and more. So we got a deal? We'll even cut you a little discount.
I still wouldn't trust him.
No.
He could always sell them out later.
He's probably going to sit on my back burner. Here,
we move to rescue Scarlet. Time grows short.
Indeed. It's more than evident Galerius had some grand purpose in kidnapping her. Delivering her from his bloodied talons may strike a heavy blow to the heart of his aims.
Perhaps, but this is far sooner than we had planned. Our allies remain scattered through every realm of Fevrith. Casting the gauntlet at Renault's feet would only send us all to an early grave.
If I may add, there are those among Galerius's adherents who willfully chose to betray the Queen those long years ago. I fear we have no hope of avoiding conflict with such base traitors.
It would seem we'll need to bolster our ranks then.
Your Highness, upon ushering you to Palavia, I labored tirelessly to build a foundation upon which the Liberation Army can take hold. I have seen great suffering in our lands, 'tis true, and yet greater resentment harbored by the oppressed and the downtrodden. I have every faith such fierce emotion will spur them to join our cause. My prince, fly your crest cross the banner of the Liberation. Spearhead the rebellion against Zenoira, and you will surely find kindred spirits ready to take arms in your name.
Then I will do just that. I only ask that you be the crutch I may lean on when the perils of war grow too great to bear alone.
Choose a heraldic achievement to represent a lane. Oh, so it's just our banner.
Mm-hmm.
Oh boy. All right, well, I think at the moment, I'm actually just going to leave us here.
You're building the rest of your herald?
Yeah, it looks like it.
Huh.
Which is... that's leafy? I'm not entirely sure. Compartment. Shield.
Oh, shield shape.
Yeah. I'm just going to... more unicorns. I think we get more later. let's see.
Oh, those are just different helmet designs. I like that one.
This one?
No, the one up above.
This one. Yeah. I was going to go to it. I was just like, this one looks creepy and evil. Just be more villain than the villains. Anyway, so, yeah, I really like this game.
Teeny tiny crown.
Okay, sure.
It looks cute.
It does look cute. Oh.
No, we need more unicorns.
Okay, scroll at the bottom. Ooh, I like that one. With the flippies? Yeah. Let's go for that. Save heraldry. Well, that was nice and easy. So I'm going to leave us here before any other dialogue
reverted.
Happens.
Hmm? It reverted.
No! Why would it do that to me? What have I done to deserve this? Oh, it's fine. It's easy to... wait, no. What?
Yeah, it went back.
No. We're just...
you're saving into a different
slot. Yeah, saving over it. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And then there's also presets, but why would I ever... ugh. Cornea. Oh, cornea. Got it. Versus the Liberation Army. But no, we need more unicorns. Hopefully we unlock more heraldry so we can have a unicorn banner, unicorn background, unicorn crown. Just everything is unicorns. Instead of a shield, it's just more unicorns. Anyway, so Unicorn Overlord is going to be available on March 8th on Nintendo Switch, Xbox S, PS5, PS4. And it's going to be physically available for Switch, Xbox X, and PS5 as well. So if you want to pick up an actual physical version, you can as well. The demo is also still available, so if you follow the link in the description below, you can play it yourselves for up to 5 hours, and your save file will carry over. It is genuinely one of the best tactical RPGs I think I've ever played, and definitely one of the best I've played in quite a long time.
And you got that just from the first, what, how long have we been playing?
Hour and a half. I think we've been going an hour and a half. Like, I mean, obviously, I'd have to play much more of it. The plot is definitely a bit of a determining factor, but I really like the gameplay in terms of the real-time elements and the auto-battling, like the combat system especially.
And I'm enjoying
is what's selling me so far.
The voice acting's really well done, and obviously we can only say great things, like wonderful things about the art.
Yes.
It's just, it's
gorgeous. It is... Vanillaware is a company that saw 3D and said, nah, we like 2D, stuck with it, and have mastered it in a way that very few companies can even claim to get close to. And you can really tell like how much experience they've just managed to accrue in this regard over the course of... I mean, they've been around for like 20, 30 years at this point.
I was really appreciating that last scene with the glow from the window, how it had the overlay on the characters themselves.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, the techniques and technology for making 2D look really nice in video games has come a long way, too. And they're making use of it in the best possible kind of ways. So the one other thing I want to say before we go is also, if this game is interesting to you, but you want to check out some other games... should really check out 13 Sentinels. It was their previous game, and I swear by that one extensively. That's part of the reason why I'm like, yeah, I think the plot will be fine.
That one had, there were time loops and there were mecha,
yeah,
right?
Time loops, mecha, and you were playing as 13 different characters with like intertwining stories, and it actually was one of the few games where I said, I'm actively going to stop streaming so I can just enjoy this game. just kind of on my own in the evenings, and I'm very glad I did. Kind of wish I'd streamed it, but it would have been a little extensive. But I will always, always shout out that game in terms of like, boy, Vanillaware makes some great ones, and I sincerely hope people like this game and they go find their old stuff too. But I guess with all of that said, one last thank you to ATLUS, Sega, and Vanillaware for sponsoring this video. It was very kind of you, it was a ton of fun. And I look forward to playing more of it on my own. But for now at least, if you like this video in any way, shape, or form, leave us a like, helps more than you know. And if you want to see more rad new games every single day, then hit subscribe because we got tons to check out and show off. But with that, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
Bye-bye.